Hey guys, I'm Tara with Tara Simon Studios, and today I'm going to be reacting to Destiny's Child in their national anthem performance. This is live, and I'm very excited. Here we go.
Multi-platinum recording group reuniting for a performance in their native Houston, the one and only Destiny's Child!
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright
stars didn't love that breath there in between that word, though. Woo! That was great. Notice how they're standing. That is a great singer stance right there. It's not feet together, especially since they're in heels. One foot is behind the other, and they're about feet to shoulder width apart. That's a power stance right there. That's allowing them to draw their power from the ground where they should be drawing it from, and essentially also keep them really on balance. When you're in heels and you're singing, adrenaline's pumping, it's really easy to just somehow like fall to one side and lose your balance, but they're very centered, all three of them. It's really nice. Keep going.
And the rock is rippling.
Yes.
The bombs bursting in air gave proof to
the nice ending there on this. Gorgeous.
That our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star?
Cool, I like that. Beautiful straight tone into vibrato there from Beyonce. Love it. That's good. Yes. Ooh, I like that. Nice. Yes! What a fantastic ending. I love that. So the national anthem is a really tricky song to sing. There are some purists who absolutely cannot stand you doing a thing to it, like, don't change a single note! Ah! It's national anthem! How dare you? It's sacrilegious. I kind of disagree with that. I sort of feel that it's such an iconic classic standard that whenever you sing it as a singer, it's sort of like, at least for me, I feel a responsibility to make it my own because it is so well known. There's already such a base medium for what people expect it to sound like. And yes, it's nice to sometimes hear it in its purest form, but when you're in a group like this and you've got three very talented singers, why not use and utilize that talent and diversify the song, not to change it beyond recognition, but to just add things where you're listening to it and you go, like that's really cool, you know, and it re-grabs your attention. We all predict what the national anthem is going to sound like in the next phrase because if you're American, you better know the song. So if you are listening to it and something grabs your attention, I think that's a job well done. I think that's success. And I think they did exactly that. It's really hard also, by the way, for those of you who've never sang in a stadium before, I have, and multiple times in different like basketball stadiums, football stadiums, baseball stadiums, they're all different, but they all have extreme delays and echoes. And that's really difficult just as a soloist to keep up with if you're not using in-ears. And sometimes I did and sometimes I didn't. The propensity is for you to wait after your phrase, after you hear the echo, and wait to catch up to your delay instead of continue on, regardless of what you're hearing outside as your voice bounces through the stadium. They were using in-ears, I'm sure, but there are three of them, and so the risk is a lot greater. So the fact that they had such clean entrances and exits for the most part was also very impressive. They had great swells, great day crescendos, and they had really cool arrangement of the end as well, and I really thought that it was a little bit vintage of them. The way that they dressed and the way that they chose their arrangement, I thought was really kind of like throwback-ish a little bit, and I liked that. I liked that a lot. So this was a great suggestion. And of course, you know, Beyonce has moved on and has done many other national anthem performances for just as big, if not bigger, venues than this that you can definitely check out. I'd be happy to react to them if you request them. Make sure if you have any requests that you put them in the comments box below. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel, hit the notifications button, like us on Instagram too, because we post free tips and tricks for your voice there as well. And if you're looking for lessons yourself, if you're wanting to take your voice from good to great, and learn how to stylize, learn how to make your voice more dynamic, expand range, all that good stuff, click on the link in the description box for private lessons. My coaches and I at TSS would be happy to help you with that. And there's a few other links there as well that you can check out, some really innovative things that we've come up with to help you guys on your singing journey, or just figure out if you should have a singing journey to begin with. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Love you. So glad that I can do this for you. And I'll see you on the next one.